In this video, I'm going to quickly show you how to set up a microphone in FL Studio and how to record and get the audio into your song. So to start off, we need to go up to Options, Audio Settings, and we need to make sure our driver is set to FL Studio ASIO or ASIO for All. Depending on which version of FL you've got, it could be ASIO or ASIO for All. And depending on which version of the ASIO driver you've got, you might need to go to this ASIO panel underneath and set your input and output. So your input needs to be whichever is your microphone that you're using. So my microphone is running through a mixing desk, which is coming up as line 3. So I'm going to select that. And output needs to be whatever you've got your headphones or speakers plugged into. But bearing in mind, you don't want the sound to be coming out of your speakers and going through the microphone. Okay, and then now that we've got the devices set up, we need to go to an empty mixer track. So I'm going to just choose track 10 for now, and I'm going to rename that mic, and I'm going to set it to a different color so I can easily see it. So next, as a precaution, and make sure we don't get any horrible feedback or anything too loud damaging our ears when we do enable the microphone, we need to make sure that this track 10 is not coming through the master channel. So to do that, we need to be selected on track 10, and then we go underneath the master down to this little bit, and it says disable send from mic to master, and that's what we want to do. So we'll click that, and now any sound that comes through here won't come out of the master and you won't hear it. Okay, so next we go just above where we usually put the effects plugins, and there's an audio input source drop down. And from here you need to select your microphone. Depending on your hardware, this might look a little bit different. You could have more or less options than this, so you might just need to click through them until you find out which one is your microphone. And you'll know when it's your microphone because as soon as you click on it, you should see your voice coming through this track. So I've got mine set up now. So now I just need to go to slot 1 and enable Edison. So now that I've got Edison on, I will be able to record straight in Edison, which is just an audio editor. So to do that, I need to change the input to now because I wanted to record as soon as I press record. But you do have other options if you wanted to record as soon as it hears some input, or if you wanted to record when you press play on your song. So that's useful for when you're recording like a loop, if you want to loop a bit of the song and record over it. That is good for that. So I'm just going to show you this setting for now. If I click record, now everything that I say is going straight into Edison. And when I'm done, I can edit it. I can chop bits off. I can go into tools and normalize it to get it to the full volume. And then when I'm finished, I can drag it using this icon straight into my song. Now, everything that I say is going straight into Edison. And the other way of doing it is to select a loop of your song. So if I had an instrumental playing here, I could select a loop of where I wanted to record over. And now in Edison, I would select record on play. Hit record, and then this is not going to start recording until I've pressed play on the song. So now it's recording, and as soon as it gets to the end of the loop, it will start again. It'll carry on recording here, but it'll put this song jump marker. So this is handy for if you wanted to keep doing loads of takes of a verse or a chorus or something like that, or a rap or whatever, and you can just keep on recording and keep going over it, and then at the end you can pick your favorite one, or you can look through them all and compare. So I'm gonna hit stop and stop, and now I can just drag the whole thing into FL like this, and you can see how it's got the marker points here. So I could chop them up there, or in Edison, if I wanted to select a single part, then you just double click on the song jump. And then if you get the one that you want, you can just drag that into your song and it'll just drag that part for you. So if you wanted to listen to things in Edison, at the moment, you won't be able to hear anything because this Edison is on track 10, and at the moment track 10 is not routed to the master track. So what you could do is load Edison up onto a different track like the master track. And then you could drag from one Edison into the other Edison. So this one is in the master channel. So now it's recording, and so now I can listen to it. I'm going to put some links to the audio equipment that I use in the description. So if you're looking for a mixing desk or a microphone or an audio interface, you can check out those links, and they're the ones that I personally use and would recommend.